The Makers Movement is really an opportunity for people to get back to understanding how things are made. But rather than saying, you know, what if or how could, you can say, I can, and be able to turn that to an opportunity right then to be able to create and make something. The 757 Makerspace is a community workshop and prototyping center. The genesis for this is if you have an idea, you can come here and make it. We've got artists, we've got crafters, we've got makers. For them to be empowered to come in and learn a tool, or they've got an idea of something they want to make, and the tool is literally just a tool. It doesn't matter what that is. So the premise here is we don't take people all the way through and teach them a lot of extra stuff they don't need. We give them just enough knowledge to be dangerous. And I say that in a positive way, in that it's just what they need to get their project, and then just a little bit more to be able to turn them loose and then let them be able to create and expand from there.
The Downtown Norfolk Council put out a request for proposals for parklets. A parklet is a park in a parking spot in the city. I had never really made anything to this scale before. When I first went to the 757 Makerspace, I met with Beau, and he was very eager to get involved.
A lot of the people in the Makerspace were just super willing to offer their help just because they were excited about the project.
The Makerspace was the perfect place to work. I had all the tools I needed and all the space I needed too, and a lot of support.
One of the things we found in Hampton Roads, with everybody coming together here, we've got a really vast background. Everyone from retirees on up to young adults, as well as kids. And they tend to come in here and people will work on their project, but on nights like Open Build Night, the first Friday of every month, people have a chance to come out, they don't have to be members, and they can just meet other people. And we're already seeing people out here that have teamed up on at least 6 or 7 different projects. The Makerspace is a benefit corporation. So what's nice about this is we've got a social purpose. And our social purpose is being able to teach people design and engineering-based thinking and manufacturing. So with our partnerships, we're able to actually take real-time products, put them into a market. They're able to sell this and see these products, get immediate feedback from that, and now they can turn that and get real results, implement that into their second prototype, their third prototype, and continue their iterations as they go to market themselves. We've got card games that are in here, so they're doing art on top of the cards. They're also making a functional game. They've got instructional learners that are here, as well as just people around that are playing this and giving real feedback, real time, that they can now take back for their next prototype. One of the nice things about being able to empower people is you can take someone that's had an idea for 10 years, 15 years, or longer, and literally within a few hours, transform that to something tangible that they can now take home and talk about and share. That builds people, that builds their dreams. They can then become the next $1 million or $1 billion business. There's tons of these kind of people that are your citizen scientist, your backyard artist, your artisans that come together to create and make. And that really gives us a great opportunity to transform not just individuals or kids or retirees or all these people in the middle, but transform just the communities that we live in as well.
Living across the line, but I was closing my eyes. Need somebody, need someone. Ooh. When I was living across the line, I was closing my eyes. Need somebody, need someone.